Hello, Blake.
Hiya.
What are we doing today? We're going to the Railway Museum.
Yeah.
And what's at the Railway Museum?
Steam engine, car, like trucks.
Wow.
Rocking.
So, what, you're going to have fun today?
Yes.
All right, let's go in.
Hello.
You ready to go in?
Welcome aboard. My name is Carson McLaughlin and I work in guard vans similar to this for approximately 41 years of my working life. And I'd like to show you just some of the things that is typical for a guard van. If you look at the rear of the guard van, you'll see a red box, and that's the toolbox used in emergency purposes, and it contains an axe, hand saw, hacksaw and a pinch bar. The part at the back of the van that's like a shelf, that's inside that is the dog box. You could have a couple of dogs in there, one either side, or you'd open either side and you change the dog in there. That was for people sending dogs, or those drovers were travelling on the train, they could put their dog in the dog box. If you look towards the ceiling, you'll see two brackets, and it contains a folding ambulance stretcher. There's also an ambulance, large ambulance box that contained splints and some bandages and all sorts of things, a very substantial ambulance box. And it was either on the wall or under the seat near the lookout. Now, getting along towards the front of the train, you'll see this big screw thing with the thread on, that is the handbrake, and that was for if the locomotive was cut off to do some shunting duties, you applied the handbrake so the train wouldn't drift away when the air brakes leaked off. You had to read your gauge and would have approximately 75 pounds of a square inch for your air pressure. You would notice that drop when the locomotive driver applied the brakes. If you needed to stop in an emergency, the tap beside the air gauge, you pull that down and lift it down till the train come to a stop. And below the air gauge, you'll see a slatted box, and that contained your tow rope, coupling, derlink, and two sprags. You needed the spare coupling because the train consisted of draw hooks and couplings to draw the train along. If you broke a coupling, you had a spare coupling. If you broke a draw hook, you could use the derlink and the coupling and get on your way again. Up to the left side, you'll see that all these switches for the lights. The lights were worked by a generator with a belt that came off the axle of the wheel and charged batteries as the train was going. On each side of the van, you notice the padded seats and there's lookouts. And you could sit on either side that you wanted to, But you ought to knew what road you were travelling on, the side that would help you the most. And then on the right hand side, you'll notice all the pigeon holes, and they were to place all the railway correspondence in station order. And as soon as you got started on your train, sort all your correspondence and have it all ready for all the stops you made. And then your van would be full of all sorts of stuff to deliver along the way. There'd be meats and breads and cream cans and anything you like. The big, great big box in the middle of the van that's chained to the handbrake is the cash box. That the purpose of it received the cash from all isolated stations where there were station mistresses. And the money they'd collect, put it in a cash bag, seal it, and we put it in the cash box. Once you lifted the lid to put it in the cash box, you could not get it out again. It was that way that once the lid closed, it fell in and you couldn't retrieve it. And the station master had a key to unlock it at the end of the line. The cupboard that's above the air brake near the ceiling, all it contained was electrical equipment that had nothing to do with the guard. The electrician didn't look after that. The large box on the floor is the guard's box. It was the personal box to the guard. It contained his writing gear, his board to write on, his hand lamp, red and green flags, detonators, and numerous other things. I hope you've enjoyed my showing around what a guard's van had from 40 years back, and I hope you enjoy your rest of your tour at the museum.
Time for Dad to put his feet up.
Why should I put my feet up? I'm 58 years old. There's 7 good years left in me yet. If they close the workshops, what am I supposed to do for 7 years?
And what about you, Melby? You're an engine driver, for heaven's sake.
Oh, I'm okay, Mum. I don't mind moving down to diesel.
I never thought I'd see the day when a son of mine would be driving a diesel.
I don't have a whole lot of choice here. I can quit and try and get another job. Not easy when you're almost 40 years of age and moving up as trains. Or I can ask for a transfer up north. They still make a steam at
the top. It comes instead of shoveling coal.
It's not just the men I'm worried about. It's the families. Whole families have grown up around the workshop, dependent on workshops. And I'm not just talking about pay happy. I'm in your father at the workshop.
Your grandfather worked there all his life. More than 50 years.
I don't know you'd find this.
Why is boy? So cool. Oh.
Come on, Thomas.
Hey. They're pushing me! They're pushing me!
Oh, you knocked down the whole building.
Oh, food, Jesse!
Hello, Thomas. How are you?
Come on, cat. They're pushing me!
Armchair ride and speeds up to 160 kilometers per hour. Faster than conventional trains. Passengers travel in air-conditioned comfort with video and audio entertainment at every seat. Snacks are available. Thank you.
Hi, Blake.
I want some help.
Do you get yourself stuck? Let's walk around and have a look. Oh, there's stairs.
Please help me.
Oh, well done. That's falling. And I got that on video.